Empowered by flight, birds typically outdistance mammals, reptiles, and amphibians in their ability to reach and colonize islands. This same long-distance filter also limits competition from other birds, reduces the spread of diseases, and keeps some bird predators from ever even reaching islands. Largely free from the factors that limit bird populations on continents, the Pacific Islands were, and in some cases still are, bird havens.
The healthy population of birds is often a reflection of the forest itself. The shifts in the abundance of birds can mean that there's shifts in the dynamics of the ecosystem.
From their position at the top of the food chain, birds strongly influence ecological processes as consumers, pollinators, and seed dispersers. On Pacific Islands, land birds pollinate many woody plant species and spread their seeds as they feed on fruit and flowers. Over long periods of time, many bird and plant species become dependent on one another for food or reproduction. As a result, bird populations marooned on islands often change, and with enough time, evolve into new species. Consequently, the land birds of Pacific Islands are composed overwhelmingly of specialized and unique species. Ever since humans began colonizing islands, we have introduced a long and growing roster of alien species. As a result, the kinds of plants and animals found on islands are becoming more similar to those on continents, usually to the detriment of native birds. The most drastic and obvious impacts, such as the introduction of cats, rats, and disease, have brought about the extinction of a large proportion of the original bird populations. Introduced pigs uproot native ferns, creating suitable habitats for bird disease-carrying mosquitoes to breed, thus further reducing native bird populations, which usually have no immunities to these diseases. Hope remains for some Pacific Island land birds in situations where they can escape alien threats by, for example, retreating to high-elevation rainforests where mosquitoes cannot survive, or where they can benefit from the thoughtful human management of their remaining habitat. Native forests in Pacific Island national parks are of great importance to the conservation of the birds themselves. Significant examples include the vibrant bird communities at Kipahulu and Haleakala National Park, Kahuku in Hawaii Volcanoes National Park, and throughout the National Park of American Samoa. Documentation and the regular monitoring of long-term trends in both native and non-native land bird populations is underway in these Pacific Island National Parks. The main method of tracking how land bird populations are changing over time involves a technique called point transect counts. Biologists stop to count birds at stations along predetermined lines, or transects, through the forest.
For example, this would be a transect that goes straight, and we go to each of these points, which is a station. What a station is basically a place where we flag and set up a point where we count birds, and then return to the same station and do the same survey that we're doing. That way we can see what changes have occurred.
A point count is our best method of determining populations of birds. During a count, we'll record every bird that we hear and see, as well as the distance from the observer to the bird.
So we stop for 8 minutes. That's the duration of the count. We keep our ears and eyes open and basically are recording every bird.
And we record it into these books. And we have a code, a four-letter code, for each species that we encounter, whether it's native or exotic.
Once you start to learn the calls, it's much easier to pick them up by voice than by sight, since most of them are hidden up in the canopy of the trees.
So it's important that we know all of their calls, every little peep that they make. We should be able to identify what bird is making it.
Canopy composition.
In addition, location, habitat type, and weather conditions are noted at each station. Information collected from these surveys, repeated routinely over many years, aids natural resource managers in understanding how land bird populations are changing over time, and provides insight on how to best manage national park lands. Birds play a vital role in Pacific Island ecosystems. They are integral to the sights, sounds, cultural traditions and experiences and fundamental functions of the native forests, protecting these special birds is nothing short of protecting the Hawaiian and Samoan forests themselves.